Hello, I'm Connor Chalice from Elara Systems, and today I'm going to show you how to build your Unreal Engine 4 project to the Oculus Quest. From this point until we get the project running, we're going to leave the Oculus Quest plugged into our PC. If you have Unreal Engine on your computer, it should have already installed NVIDIA CodeWorks, and included in NVIDIA CodeWorks are the Android Debug Bridge and every NDK, SDK, and JDK that you will need. But we all know how computers are, and so here's how you download those components just in case. The first program that we're going to download is the Android Studio. What we really need is Android Debug Bridge, and that's just a part of the studio.
Next thing that we need is the latest NDK for our operating system and architecture. I'm using Windows 64-bit, and so I'm going to download this one. NVIDIA CodeWorks for Android is the third and last thing that we need to download, so we're going to scroll down here until we find CodeWorks for Android. So click it. Before we install any of these programs, we need to make sure that Unreal Engine 4 and Epic Games are both closed. I need to open up my Task Manager and verify in background processes that they are closed.
Once we've verified that those are closed, we can move on to our install.
So we're going to navigate to NVIDIA CodeWorks now and set this up.
So starting at our local disk, we're going to find Program Files, open up Epic Games, and then Engine 4.22.
Go inside Engine, Extras, Android Works, and then Windows 64. Run the installer. That pops up, hit Next, hit Next.
You may choose a different installation directory, but remember where it is. And I personally disable usage collection. Once the component manager is open, select standard installation. This will choose all of the programs that are not currently installed on your PC. When you're ready, hit next.
Accept the licenses. That's going to take a few minutes to install, and then when it's finished, hit next, and then finish.
When this dialog appears, restart your device, and then move forward. So now, go inside of the device that you used to set up the Oculus Quest initially, and hit the Oculus app. Once you're here, you're going to navigate to Settings in the bottom right. You'll see a list of all the devices that you've set up using this app, so click the one that you have currently, select More Settings, and then verify that Developer Mode is enabled. We need this to put our project onto the Quest. Inside of the headset, we need to do two things. The first of which is navigate to Library and verify that Unknown Sources is enabled. If it is not enabled, try restarting your headset. If that doesn't work, go back to the device that you used to set up the Oculus Quest and verify that Developer Mode is enabled.
Now, go to your desktop and open up your search bar. Type in CMD or command prompt, launch it, and in the console, type in ADB devices. Once you press enter, this will come up with a list of Android devices that are plugged in. If you see your Quest, then you're free to move on. Now what you want to do is launch Unreal Engine 4.22 from Epic Games. We're going to wait for this to launch. So go to New Project, Blueprint, Blank, and we're going to want to build to mobile slash tablet. We want our quality set to scalable 3D or 2D, and we don't want any starter content. I'm going to name my project real fast, and then we're going to hit Create Project. This will launch a default project. You'll notice that I have plugins and project settings open. In order to find these, navigate to Edit, and at the bottom, under Configuration, you'll see both of them. So, go back to Plugins and scroll down to the very bottom, under Virtual Reality. You're going to make sure that the only one of these that are ticked is Oculus VR. You'll see that I have Steam VR enabled by default. Make sure you disable that. We can postpone restarting until we finish the rest of our settings. Underneath Project and Description, we're going to navigate for Start in VR and click it. The next thing we're going to do is go to Maps and Modes and set our startup map and default map to the map that we're currently going to work on. After this, we can navigate to Target Hardware. Right here, you can verify that your build target is for mobile and tablet, and that your content is scalable 3D or 2D. Next, we want to go to Supported Platforms and disable the All Platforms button. From there, disable every other input except for Android. After this, we'll go to Input underneath Engine and disable this control scheme. It's built for mobile, and we're not using a touchscreen. Now scroll down to Platforms and select Android, which should be the first one. What we want to do is configure the APK packaging for Android. After that, we're going to change the minimum SDK version and target SDK version to 25. The next setting is enabling Gradle instead of Ant, and packaging our game data inside of a .apk. We also need to enable full screen interactive for KitKat and above devices. Continue scrolling down and you'll find two more settings that need to be enabled. The first of which is configure the Android manifest for deployment to Oculus Mobile, and the second is remove Oculus signature files from the distribution APK. Both of these need to be enabled. We'll now scroll down to Android SDK, and we want to verify that the Android SDK, NDK, and JDK all have locations pathed. They should be inside of NVPack, which is where NVIDIA CodeWorks stores its files.
So for this project, I just put an environment object in with a pre-baked texture from 3ds Max, and we're going to use that as our scene.
And we'll launch to the Quest. We'll wait a moment for it to load, and then we can go inside the headset and verify that it's working. Thank you for joining us, and good luck with your projects.